Hi there, in this tutorial, I will show you how to grant a user access to a specific Azure Databricks workspace without giving them visibility to any other resources in your Azure subscription. We're going to achieve this by assigning them a workspace level Azure RBAC access control and add them as user inside the Databricks Admin Console. Let's get started. If you're new to this channel, please click on the subscribe button and toggle on the bell icon to be informed of new videos. Now, the first thing we need to do is to create the user in the entry ID of the Azure portal. To achieve that, I'm going to navigate to the portal.azure.com and I'm going to search for entry, and I can see Microsoft entry ID, which is known as Azure Active Directory in the past. I'm going to click on that, and under the manage, I want to click on users, and I can see the option to create a new user. Now, this is going to be created within our organization, so I'm going to click on that, and I can see under the basics, I'm going to provide the user principal name as well as the mail nickname, display name, and password. And once I'm done, I'm going to click on review plus create, but I'm not going to create another user so I can come back to the list of what I've got already. So I want to click on the users, and I can see I've got Enoch at Cornerstone Analytics 1 on Microsoft.com, and I can see Zoe. So let's say I want to grant Zoe Abiola the access to my Databricks workspace. I'm going to come back here, and I can do that by going to the accounts.azuredatabricks.net, and I can see under the user management, I've got the Abiola as the account admin and as billing admin. So to add a new user, I'm going to click on this add user. By the way, you can see accounts users can use the account console to view and connect to their workspaces. So let's add a new user. Now I'm going to provide the email address of the user and of course the full name. So I'm going to type the email address here right now. So I can see this is the email address, which is consistent with what I've got in the Microsoft Entra ID. And I'm going to provide a name. I'll call this one Zoe Abiola. And once I'm done, I'm going to click on add user. And the user is now added. So I can define the kind of roles I want them to play in this account. So I'm going to come to the roles, and I can grant them the account admin, which allows them to manage workspaces, users, and groups, cloud resources settings, and so on. And I can also, you know, grant them the marketplace admin or the billing admin if I want them to be able to manage all our budgets. So I'm not going to do all of that. So when I come back to the user manager, I can see the green check mark and user is now added. Now, for the user to access the workspace, they need the permission at the workspace level in order to achieve that. So I'm going to come to the workspaces, and I can click on this, and I'm going to come to the permissions. So this is where, you know, security and governance comes into play. So under the permissions, I can see I've got only myself as the person that have access to this workspace. So I'm going to click on add permissions, and I can add permission for user, group, or service principal, and I can define the level of their permission. So I'm going to come here, and I'm going to search for Zoe, and I can see the email automatically populated and the name. So I'm going to click on that. I can even add more users if I choose, depending on the job function and what they need to do. So when I come to the permissions, I can make them to be an admin, so they have the same full privilege unlike me, but in this case they are just a normal everyday user, not an admin. So I'm going to click on save. There we go, we have the new user Zoe Abiola, and I can see the permissions they've got. Now, how can they access? It's so straightforward. I'm going to come to the configuration, and I can see the URL of the specific workspace. So I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to just give to this person, maybe via email address or chat or whatever, so they can log in and have access. So I'm going to come to this browser, Firefox, and I'm going to paste the Databricks workspace URL. Now, this is going to ask them to authenticate if they're doing it for the first time. So they have to authenticate, and voila, we have access to the workspace. Now that this user has been granted permission to the Databricks workspace, you may be wondering, are they going to be able to view and read data from the Unity catalog that exists in this workspace? Definitely not. even if we give them Azure Rubrik Access Control to the Databricks workspace, the user still need permissions inside Utility Catalog to read data. I'm going to show you. I'm going to quickly come back to the admin and I want to go to the same workspace. So I want to go to the catalog and I've got this cloud underscore UC and Lakeflow underscore UC catalog. I'm going to expand and I can say I've got this marketing AI and sales and some couple of schemas and data. So when I come back here, of course, they'll be able to see the names of the catalog as well as the schema and the name of the table, but they will not be able to see the data. How do I know this? Let's see together to the catalog. And once that's ready, of course, they can see the list of the Unity catalog. So in this case, this is governed by Metastore. So this simply means only the Metastore admin can access the content. So you can even see Metastore only access, so you can see the name of the owner and the updated. But when I expand the catalog, of course you can see the name of the schemas. So when I expand the marketing, for now I can see the tables, so they can see the names but they cannot see the content. For instance, let's click on the sales trend 24. When I click on that, they can see the names of the columns, including data types, but you can see the sample data tab has been grilled out. You can see you are only permitted to see metadata for this asset. Request additional permissions from the objects page. So they are not going to be able to see the content because they don't have the permissions to be able to do so. And of course, when I come to the details, they can see the type, whether it is managed or external tables, but they are not able to see the permission history as well as the quality and so on and so forth. So this has been restricted. So for them to be able to see the data, to be able to read, to be able to query and so on, we need to grant them the permission, and that's what I'm going to cover in the next video. So please stay tuned and subscribe to the channel, like and share with your friend if you appreciate the free knowledge I'm sharing with you. Thank you and bye for now. Cheers.